I was able to get all three Spider-Gwens like a true Funko junkie this week. Got the regular version right here. There's her artwork. The hooded but unmasked version from Walgreens. I got this one thanks to Franklin McGinnis. He saw it at the store. He knew I'd want it, and he knows my struggle and my dysfunctional relationship with Walgreens. He got it for me. I sent him a pop and a dunny in return. Really cool of him. Thanks again, Franklin. And the Hot Topic, unhooded and unmasked Spider-Gwen. I can already tell that this little lady isn't going to stand on her own. She seems very top-heavy with her hair, and her feet look pretty tiny. Yeah, she goes back, so good thing it comes with a stand. But, you know, these Spider-Gwens are really cool. That's why I bought all three. I really like just the paint job on the body. Look how small the webbing is. And it looks really good. Yeah, overall, cool body sculpt, cool paint on it. One of the cool things about Spider-Gwen is how sick this costume is. It's really awesome. The hair sculpt is really great. Yeah, I really like it. It's going to be hard to pick a favorite out of these three. When I first saw the glam shots of this one, I was like, whoa, dude, I really need to get that one. It's my favorite one of this whole Marvel wave. It's really well done. The body's the same on all of them. But yeah, like this one, since it has the blue webbing up here too, really balances out with the turquoise, the pink, and the black, and the white. Really like it. Pretty clean. I mean, pretty simple back here, but it's just such a cool design that the simplicity really looks awesome. And I can tell this one's weighted a little better. And this one does stand on its own if you don't want to use a stand. But yeah, really cool. I really like the gradient of pink around the eyes. Just really, really awesome pop. This one's going to be hard to beat. I really like when they make the common this cool looking. And this is definitely the most sought after of all three of the Spider-Gwens. Got those pop hunters going crazy. And yeah, man, she's really cool. You got the cool hood on here. Got the hair poking through. The only thing I can critique on it is that I wish that they would have put the blue lines. See those blue turquoise lines on the hood here, on the pink? I wish they would have put them on this one too. For some reason, they left those out. I'm sure it was something to do with the hair, you know. It's a tight spot, but they still could have added them. Because, I mean, look how small these lines are here. Got tiny little lines here. They got plenty of space to add some blue lines. It would have looked a lot cooler. And on their packaging, you can see blue lines on there, so I wish they would have added them, but she looks cool nonetheless. I mean, the Spider-Gwen just has one of the coolest costumes, and I'm really happy that I was able to acquire this one. Alright, so this girl's the Hot Topic one, Walgreens one, and the common one, even though this common has also been kind of difficult to find. You know, I really like that Walgreens one, I really like the Hot Topic one too, but I'm gonna have to say that the common one is my favorite this time, and I really hope that's a trend that continues, because I really do like when Funko makes the common version the coolest one. Like, the Suicide Squad pops that came out recently, I think the common Harley Quinn, besides maybe the metallic version of the common Harley Quinn, is the coolest looking one. And I really like when they do that, because not everybody can get all these. Not everybody has the time to get all of them, or good friends like Franklin that will get the hard to get ones, you know. So thanks again, Franklin. He really allowed me to complete my trio of bad bitches.